All right, here we go. Don't blink. There it is. Did you see it? Again. And now zoomed in and a different angle. Don't blink. Here it comes. Slow motion. Oh yeah, there it is. The International Space Station transiting the sun. Absolutely amazing. I'll show you how to do this. Let's look at this again. Zoomed in even more. Yes. Now, does that look awesome or what? Trust me, this is super simple to do. One more time. Zoomed in even more. Check it out. Slowed down as well. Oh yeah. Absolutely insane. Let me show you how to do this. It's simple. You're gonna Google or search ISS Transit Finder, and it'll be the first link that pops up. I'll actually put the link in the description as well, but this is how you get to it. And then once you are in the website, ISS Transit Finder, you're gonna set your location, your latitude, your longitude, your elevation. And to make it easy on yourself, if you're not sure about your own coordinates, you can just click on auto detect and it'll put it on there automatically. And then you can set the time to look for when exactly the object that you want, which in this case is the International Space Station, will transit the sun. So do know that you can do this also with the moon, right? When the space station transits the moon as well. And you can also do it with other stations such as the Chinese space station, the Tiangong space station. But let's do this with the ISS. Let's look for exactly when it will transit anything, which whether it's the sun or the moon. So you can set your time span and then see how far you're willing to drive to that location to go see it. You can reduce this to like 10 or 5 and it'll still show your location. So let's check it out. And then we're gonna click on calculate. The closest date was today, which is when I'm recording this, November 29th. It'll tell you where exactly it's going to cross, where the ISS will cross, and it'll tell you at the exact time, of course. Another way is to go back and just leave the 80 kilometers calculation, the auto calculation. Let me put December 26th for the dates, calculate. Let's start beginning tomorrow now. Let's start beginning the next day now. Calculate a month's worth of time. So once again, it showed me my date for today when I already caught it. And it'll show you other dates for other crossings, whether that be the International Space Station or whether that be the Chinese station, which is a Tiangong station, which that's really cool too. They actually look similar if you, whichever one you capture, they're going to look pretty similar. They look like a Star Wars TIE fighter or starfighter. It looks really amazing. And so what you're going to do is you will want to look up exactly when it crosses the actual object, whether that be the sun or the moon. And you'll know if it's the sun or the moon because clearly the sun looks like this. It looks like the daytime yellow. And then the moon, it'll tell you too. It'll tell you if it's the moon. It'll say moon close pass. Or like on here, it says sun close pass. But what you want is for it to be exactly across the object because that's where you'll be able to actually see it more clearly, right? So you look for when in your location it'll transit. As you see, you can also look at the Hubble Space Telescope. That's pretty cool. I don't know if it has the JWST as well, the James Webb on here. Maybe it does. I'm not sure. Maybe not. But that is really, really neat. And as you see also here, there are no more within the next month, at least for my location, there are no more instances where it'll cross exactly. Let's say I want to get the moon, the ISS transiting the moon. There's nothing. So I would have to keep checking, right, to see when, let's say within the next month, maybe for January or February, change your dates. Change your dates, return to the settings, and you can change your dates to another time period. I think there's a limit as to how far you can check. So, you know, just be checking every couple weeks, every few days or so as the calendar continues to open up and they give you your dates. Here we go. So there's a moon transit January 1st. It'll give you the time. So this is actually, what is this? in the afternoon with the moon, this will be pretty, might be a little difficult, but I'm sure you could still get it, or I could still get it. And another way that I want to show you to look at this through your sky map or sky guide, any astronomy app that features your sky celestial coordinates and things like that, you're going to want to also check it on there too. The timing, which does match this, but you still want to prepare yourself as much as you can. And you want to make sure you have your scope out. Have it outside well in advance. You know, prepare, be out there an hour, leave your scope outside about an hour in advance, and or at least 30 minutes out there. Make sure you're ready to go. But you want to start recording, I'd say about 5 minutes before the actual time. You want to hit record on your C-Star. You want to hit your screen recording or your record video on your telescope, right? On your software, on your app. So here's one with the moon transit. And let me show you. So this, you know, this is okay, but I rather have it maybe more up here, like towards the center. But you know, you can't always get what you want. It's kind of hard. You have to just continue checking to see when you want that perfect, whatever you feel is perfect for you, a transit, right? Here's one with another sun transit, right? So it comes up every couple weeks or so. You'll be able to probably catch something, or every few weeks. And let's check on the astronomy app on the sky guide, how you should also see it on there as well, just to confirm that this is actually accurate, which it is. But this is another cool way to confirm this. So here's the Sky Guide app. You're going to put the date that you know it's going to transit the object, whether that be the sun or the moon, right? 10:38 a.m. is when it was going to pass today. So I'm going to click on Space Station. And if you see the Space Station, it's going to go really, really quickly, right? So if you notice here, I'm just going to move this. If you notice, it's very, very quick. I mean, it's like a split second. You only have like a second to capture that, which is why you want to be preparing yourself. Hit record before that time, like at least a few minutes before. So if you notice it definitely transits the sun right at that time that it said on the ISS Transit Finder website that it would transit the sun. There it is. There it is. That's really cool. As you see, it's right there. So at 10, it's like you just have that split second. The station is right there. So that's it. That's how you do it.